Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. Today we are going to play with a Škoda T27, which was sold for 7,000 gold, if I'm not mistaken, in the bled market. And I believe it is about the time to go for a spin, right? We are going to play three battles, and I have three different builds prepared for you. We are going to start with a casual build right here. After that, we will replace ventilation for rotation mechanism. And then we are going to replace rotation mechanism for something else. Maybe even turbo or something. I don't know. We'll see. We will figure this out meanwhile, right? And without further ado, let's go into the battle, fellas. Overall, speaking about the Škoda, Škoda, in my opinion, is worse version of the Progetto. It doesn't really matter how you are going to look at this. Progetto is just simply better, right? Overall, I was extremely excited when Škoda came into the game, and I thought it's going to be something like TVP or like Škoda Tier 9. But overall, I don't really think this section is available now, because Progetto is simply so much better, right? At least that's what I think. Obviously, feel free to leave your comment down below, and feel free to correct me if you think I am wrong. Maybe you are enjoying Škoda more yourself instead of Progetto. And obviously, you can always send a big wet kiss for me and Kyler's by leaving the thumbs up. It always helps the channel out, because more likes, bigger chance, and more people is going to reach the video. So that would be a great thing from your side. Thank you very much for that, fellas. Anyways, what is the goal? First of all, I want to take this position here, and I want to bang everyone which will try to go up. As an example, by the looks of it, Borat is thinking about going up right here. And if he will, he is going to regret his life choices, and he is going for it. That's beautiful. Let's see. Borat 1. Borat 2. Borat 3. Nice. 2 out of 3 is not bad whatsoever, and luckily Borat did not made any damage whatsoever for us, so that's all that matters, right? We haven't lost any HP, we gave the full clip for Mr. Borat, right? And obviously Borat is pretty much the different version of the Škoda T27, and in my opinion Borat is just simply better as a tank, right? Anyways, we are not here to complain about this vehicle, we are here to make this tank work, right? That's the whole idea, and that's the whole plan. So let's see. One thing which is worth to mention, currently we are playing in the losing spawn over there, at least in my opinion, right? And as you can see, all trees are knocked down here. So we need to figure out where enemies could sit. How about here? What do you think? I'm going for a blind shot. One. I'm not entirely sure I'll be hitting someone or not, but I'm just going fully out, right? I would rather test to hit someone with a blind shot instead of complaining afterwards for not trying, right? I am kind of waiting until they will lose just tiny touch more HP here, because whenever they will, we will try to eliminate them from the game. What I could possibly do, I could go like this, right, to take this position and simply be hidden from the Progetto. And you know what, I'm going to do this. Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, I am risking for the biscuit right here. That's the first, that's the second, and that's the third. Beautiful. And now we are trying to be safe from the Mr. Progetto, which is sitting here, and while we are reloading, right, we are helping our guys for obvious reasons. We are helping our guys for an obvious reasons, my friends. And now this guy is in the deep, 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 deep shithole, my lovely friends. Keep this in mind. So, Progetto just creeped our guy out. That's completely fine. And what do we want to do? We want to go for a Progetto. I'm not even going to bother to clip this TVP Wato, because I simply don't care about him, even though if I would take one for the team. This guy is dead. Excellent. And now we have an angle for TVP Wato. TVP Wato is considering his life choices, and we are hitting him once. That's completely fine. Once is more than enough. And now we are going to take a better position right here. Here we go. We are sitting already for at 1,700 damage, which I think is quite great performance already, but we are just starting. And yes, we still have a lot of time to make many good things happening. As an example, now as you can see, IS is sitting in quite bad position himself, so that's good. Ay, my brother from other mother, how are you feeling? If you are comparing TVP VTU against the Škoda, even though they are the same tank, they are the same level tanks, I mean... In my opinion, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, TVP VTU should not even exist in the game. We should have a Škoda T27 as a typical tier 8 tank, right? And it would make so much more sense to go for this line because you are already introduced to the auto loaders, right? And so on, so on. And it's way more like Škoda T50 or TVP or how it's called, the TVP 5051, right? It's so much more like it. But once again, not much what we can do about this, fellas. World of Tanks have their own ways of thinking and making money, if we can say so. Anyways, 10 seconds left. After that, we are going to bang the living hell out of the Panther M10. I believe that's completely understandable. And once again, what we are simply waiting for, we are simply waiting until this Panther will get spotted. It's not a victory yet. Be sure about this, fellas. It is not a victory yet. And I believe this first battle is going to be very, very, very nice for us, right? Panther idea, beautiful. That's one for the team. That's two for the team. And that's three for the team. Very, very nice. It's always nice to have this burst of fire, which is taking like 3.6 seconds, and you are getting yourself 700 damage. It's very nice. You can say whatever you want, it's just beautiful, right? Obviously, Panther M10 is going to get slaughtered right here because we have a lot of Scorpions, which is simply going in front like there is no tomorrow, right? But once again, that's completely fine. I am thinking how to punish this guy right here, and I'm going for it. That's one for the team, that's two for the team, and that's three for the team. Beautiful. Two shots directly hit them, that's very nice. Okay, I am going to load high explosives, and there is only one reason why I'm going to load high explosives, because all of the tanks which is left, they are made out of paper, right? And we have, instead of making 720 alpha damage, we have like closer to 900 alpha damage, plus opportunities to do the critical hits and so on, so on. So what I want to see the Sue making a bit of pressure here, right? That's all I care about. Mr. Scorpion is making pressure right here, that's okay. Double Sue, aye, one Sue just hit us in the face, which is not very, very nice. And you know what, we need to figure out how to abort from this. We need to figure out how to run away, and I'm risking for it because otherwise I'm going to get slaughtered here. Even though I lost quite a bit of HP going down the hill, it is worth it in the end of the day. Skill, why is it worth it, you are saying? The answer is extremely simple. Wow, fellas. Both of the Scorpions are thinking about trying to flank us, but luckily it's not the case, and Sue just died. Nice. Can he survive? Yeah, he survived. Shame. I definitely did not expect this guy to jump on me, but hey, he did that, so I can't complain whatsoever. Nice play by the platoon of the Su 130. Not much what I can change about this. Meanwhile, our Scorpion Jesus is saying, aha, so soon we are going to figure out who is better, Scorpion, the Russian version of the Scorpion, which is Su 130 PM, or the Scorpion G. Our Scorpion obviously is making pressure because he's not down to one-shotable. Our Leo, meanwhile, is capping the base, and our Scorpion, one of the Scorpions are flanking, and another Scorpion is thinking, no, mother trucker, peek, I will show you how the Scorpion is looking like. Our Scorpion had high explosive loaded, and enemy Sue is saying, yeah, exactly, you hear that right. It was very, very, very silent note of, that's how the things was looking like. Anyways, one of the other Scorpions took one for the team, but it doesn't really matter. Our 1357 is thinking, you mother trucker, spit. Unfortunately, only one spit of a trade. Our Scorpion is thinking, I have high explosives. He just fired. Our Scorpion just fired. I repeat, our Scorpion just fired. He messed up quite a bit because he thought that was the enemy, I assume, but it's completely fine. Relax, take it easy. Or maybe he's simply loading high explosives now. Enemy Sue is trying to escape. Our Leo is capping the base, and our Scorpion missed another shell. Doesn't really matter. Victory is victory, even in the ass And once again, I'm quite happy with this performance, what we have done. I need to give a big fat thumbs up for Enemy Sue for finding the balls to jump on me, okay? Usually I'm the one which is jumping everywhere and failing. We are not going to speak about the Anus Panther video, are we? So yeah, let's see. Very good game, 4,300 damage, very, very, very nice, first class, always happy to see those, and that's what we have. Also, very, very, very strong play by the team of the Su-130PM, so big fat thumbs up for them, right? They deserve the score which they have here, nice. Anyways, what we are going to do, time to change the build. We are going to get rid of the ventilation and we are going to use the rotation mechanism because why the heck not, right? So tank might become a bit more agile, as wrong as it sounds, and the tank might become a bit better in a way, right? But obviously it is completely up to you, speaking about equipment which you want to use. And in the same time, fellas, if you are searching for equipment which you want to use and you have no bloody clue on the tier 10, tier 9 tanks, I got you covered. I made the list with the three different builds on the tank. Feel free to check the description, click on the Mark of Excellence document or Google document and click on the threesome. Everyone wants to click on the threesome, right? So here you go. There, that's where you are going to find the builds and everything, and I hope it's going to make your life just tiny touch easier, right? So you you can make your decisions with what kind of build you want to use from the suggested ones as an example, right? Anyways, what do we want to do now? Škoda T27. We have extremely good matchmaking here. We are playing against the tier 7s, which is always nice, although they have two artists, but it's not changing the situation too much for us. What is the plan? The plan for us is to go a bit more aggressive here. Why the heck not to do so, right? As you can see, Škoda is becoming a bit more agile and we are turning just tiny touch quicker, which is always nice and always welcome if you would ask me. So, What is the position which we want to take? Ooh, Borat. Look at this. One for the team, two for the team. And what Borat? Fellas, I want to report missing Borat. There was a beautiful tank somewhere and he disappeared. I don't even know what happened. I have no clue what happened, fellas. Obviously, Borat overestimated his powers, and with a Borat, you can't afford to be that aggressive, because otherwise you are not going to enjoy yourself. Speaking about enjoying yourself, what do you think about this Tiger P? I am very, very well aware of that this Tiger P is a fucker, right? I'm very, very well aware of that. Believe me, I am. Meanwhile, there is Indian Panzer. And what I am thinking about, I have a perfect angle for Indian Panzer. And I even have better angle for the Vaka since we managed to track him. So here we go. That's a fully clipped tank. And now I need to think how to escape from here before it's too late. Skill, why you are speaking about escape since you have such a great angle for all of those guys over there? Yes, I do have a nice angle, but in the same time we need to understand one thing. There is two Jeffs, and for them to outplay me, they are one click away from doing so, right? So this is very, very important thing to mention. Extremely important thing to mention, my lovely friends. Meanwhile, the Scorpion is thinking about being a bit more aggressive. That's completely fine. I'm banging him in the face and he is being lit on fire. Nice. Okay, let's keep running. I know our team is winning by 3,000 HP already, but in the same time we have a lot of things to do here. Skill, what do you mean a lot of things to do? Well, you see, the Scorpion is the biggest problem here. Whenever Mr. Scorpion will get banged, whenever Mr. Scorpion will get eliminated from the game, we can actually return to our position. We can actually destroy the Tiger P, which is a fucker, and so on, so on. Or maybe I could even take this position here and simply peek here once again. But once again, it is quite complicated, fellas. It is quite complicated if you would ask me. Currently, I have the thinking process in my head, okay? Do I want to eliminate the Mr. Scorpion? And you know what? He is a little mother trucker, which we are going to get rid of very, very soon. Let's go. My biggest fear, the Sue never spotted. Oh, okay. Okay. Like I said, my biggest fear, Sue never ever was spotted, and now we know where Sue is. So both of those guys are kind of down to one shotable, so now we can simply hold this angle and be annoying as F for both of those guys. Plus, on top of that, if it's not enough, we have the Tiger P over there, which we could potentially clip out, right? And obviously there is a T43, which we can also clip out, right? So all we need to do, we need to be very, very patient right here, fellas, and we need to wait a bit. Meanwhile, enemy Jeff is obviously hitting us directly, and I'm very, very sad, but by the looks of it, I am priority target for the enemy Jeff. Shame on him. That's okay. Look, what is the plan now? Now, the plan is very, very simple. Can we find the right angle for this mother trucker idea? And the answer is absolutely yes. That's a first missed shot, which is quite sad. Another hit shot, that's okay. And Scorpion is taking another for the team. Actually, Scorpion is dodging the shot from literally 2 meters distance. And Arta politely said, Skill, you want to play the game and you are using the keyboard? Shame on you, Skill. Shame on you, obviously. I could expect that. Once again, I mentioned that in the first moment of the battle. There is 2 Jeffs, so for obvious reasons, I need to be very, very careful. And that's why I effed off at the first place. But that's okay. The main problem of the Škoda is the gun handling, in my opinion. So that's the worst thing for this tank. But that's okay. I can't complain too much. I made the decisions which I wanted myself, and I need to give a big fat thumbs up for a Scorpion, which was playing very, very well, and obviously he banged me without even asking my name, right? Now I am thinking, what is the third build which we could use on this vehicle, fellas? What is the third build which we can actually use for this tank? I believe one of the options could be to replace optics completely. What do you think? We are going to be blind pigeon, but in the same time, we are going to have the best gun handling which we can actually build. And I am thinking about the third valuable option for a tank, because once again, not everyone is spotting for themselves. Some people is playing way, way, way safer, and they don't really care how much view range they have. So I think this is going to be the third option. Obviously, I prefer one of those two, which you saw in the first battles, right? Anyways, not the greatest game of all time. Definitely only 2,500 damage and 100 assisting damage. But once again, well deserved, and we got what we deserved, or what we earned, I suppose to say, right? Unfortunately, the Jeff's enemy artist reacted very, very well, and they was always ready to smack us in the head. But that's okay. That's life, right? Okay, so what do we have? We are second by the damage. We are fourth by experience, which is completely fine. Big fat thumbs up for 1-2, which played actually very, very well right there, and he wasn't afraid of the Jeff's whatsoever. So, what do we want to do? We want to replace this for this. We don't need rotation mechanism in this slot, and we need rotation mechanism right here. I know I could do that cheaper, but I don't really care about that. I have plenty of gold to spare. So what do we have? We have 414 meters view range, and with the optics we have actually with improved ventilation on ventilation purge, or however it's called, right, we have 418 camo, but view range. But once again, the most important thing for us is how the gun is going to behave. Are we going to be able to bang everyone left, right, and center, or what? That's the question, right? So let's go. Abbey, tier 7, tier 9 battle. We are middle tier. There is only one Jeff, which is always welcome and always very, very, very nice. Good. Okay. What is the plan? What is the plan? What is the plan? I know one thing, I forgot to show you the profit, so I'm going to show all profits after the game, okay? I am always forgetting this, because usually when I'm streaming, I'm not going into that section to check out how much credits we are making. That's the thing. Bad habit of mine, right? Decisions. I think I'm going to play somehow differently now. What do you mean, Skill, you are going to play somehow differently now? I'm going to go somewhere over there, and I will try to clip the person which is going like this, because usually there is one guy which is doing this kind of strategy, right? At least that's what I want to believe. At least that's what I want to believe, my lovely friends. Let's see. Are we going to be lucky or not so much? So, okay, CS-44 is here. Okay, that's understandable. And couple of light tanks are there. Do we have a good angle to overall clip them when they are playing over there or not really? That's a one for the team. That's two for the team. And he's on fire. Beautiful. Okay, that's the start. Looks like this is a very, very, very nice angle. And I should use this more often, right? We have the Panther 2, which is token, which is making pressure here, but that's completely fine. 4 seconds on the timer, and I believe we can find the angle to clip maybe Jet Panther. I believe so. That's one for the team, that's two for the team, and that's three for the team. Maybe the third shot did not hit, but it doesn't really matter. Gun handling is looking, to be fair with you, just tiny touch better. But once again, this might be my imagination and maybe my illusion, right? Also could be very, very possible. What our Anus Panther is doing here, that's interesting position. Anyways, Ty59 decided to be aggressive, and soon he's going to change his mind, my lovely friends. I don't really mind if I would take one for the team, and it was completely unnecessary. He is dead. Beautiful. Okay. Score is looking very, very, very nice, but in the same time, what we need to keep in mind, the enemies will try to flank us this way, right? And in fact, try to flank us in this way, it would be, to be fair with you, quite underestimatement. They are already flanking us in this way, right? So, decisions. What do we want to do? 1-2 TM have very powerful position here, that's a fact. So we need to watch out for this guy. And even though we have 500 HP advantage, or we had 500 HP advantage, it doesn't really mean we are winning this battle, because once again, there is a lot of stuff still to do for us. Meanwhile, Leo might try to make a bit... Leo might try to go a bit backwards. That's what I would love to see, my lovely friends. Anyways, wait. Wait, we have all time in the World of Tanks going a bit up here, that's okay. And now we have a very nice angle, although I might get spotted myself, but once again, that's okay. Can't complain too much. Still, our team is still winning by HP, but we are losing the 3 guns, which is quite sad thing. But once again, not much what we can do about this. Meanwhile, speaking about the guns, one of the enemy guns just took vacations. Beautiful, very nice. Very, very nice. Any autoloader right there in the World of Tanks, fellas, they are those sneaky mother truckers, which is just getting the position, right? From where you can be annoying for the enemy forces, and you are pretty much making them to suffer whenever they are deciding to play the game. This is pretty much the whole point of the autoloaders, my lovely friends. That's not a direct hit. That could be a direct hit, and this definitely is not a direct hit. That's okay. Once again, I have a lot of time, right? So what I can do, I can go with some blind shots. I can try to make it work, right? Anyways, the decision which I'm going to make now is quite straightforward. What we want to do, we want to help our team which is playing here. Our Centurion is having quite a bit of troubles, right? But we are not complaining too much about this, because we are about to clear this side. We have 3 in the magazine, which is enough to kill the M103, and hopefully we are going to reach him in time, right? Although our Centurion is suffering quite a bit, but it's not changing the fact we are going to help this guy not to die. Or maybe he's going to die anyways, because 1-2 TM managed to get the right angle. Anyways, the Tiger is right there, so I'm trying to find a better angle. There is one for the team, and he's dead. Nice, beautiful. Okay, what to do now? There is one of the enemy tanks, which is Scorpion, which is sitting here, right? It is completely fine. So what do we want to do? We want to flank this beautiful mother trucker. How we want to flank this this tank? There is 2 options. I could go like this, or I could go like this. But you know what? Since our team is winning, I'm just going straight forward. I don't really care if he's waiting for me here or not really, right? It doesn't change anything. Plus, on top of that, there is a chance we are going to spot the Jet Panther, which is going up the hill, if he is going to do that, right? So, do they have Scorpion here? No, they do not have Scorpion here. That's okay. Now what we are waiting for, we are waiting until the Jet Panther will get spotted. He might get spotted when he is trying to escape, or whenever he is going up the hill. As you can see, he decided to go for top of the hill, and he is dead. Beautiful. all we need to do now, we need to load high explosive clip, right? And we want to see the scorpion. I am very, very well aware of that. I could actually hit this CS-44 couple of times before going on the reload, but oh well, mistakes were made. What can you do, right? So, Mr. Scorpion, where you are sitting at, what is the chance the scorpion is waiting for us right here on this corner? This is the question. What is the chance Mr. Scorpion is waiting for us right here? And as you can see, it's not the case. Interesting. So where the flying F Scorpion escaped? Obviously, enemies have art and that's completely understandable. Not the first time, not the last time, right? Scorpion is right here. Okay, I have high explosive clip. I don't really mind about it too much and I am just going like this. I bounced both of the shots for CS-44, but once again, can't complain. I was thinking about finding the Scorpion myself, but it is how it is, right? So as you can see, all three of the builds can actually work very, very well, and all three builds are actually competitive, at least in my opinion, right? I think it is completely up to you which one of those you are going to pick. Personally, I prefer to go with a view range, but in the end of the day, everything is depending on your style, my lovely friends. If you don't really care about the view range that much, then simply pick the build which we are having right now, right? And you are going to have the very, very, very good gun handling, and you won't be able, and enemies won't be able to do pretty much anything for you, right? Meanwhile, I'm trying to rig Brother in Arms, because Brother in Arms rigging is always nice, and oh my bananas. Unfortunately, this is the bug in the game when we cannot rig Brother in Arms, because he invited me, I even invited him, and both requests got denied. Shame. Oh well, one medal less for us, not much what we can change there. So yeah, I'm actually happy with our session with a Škoda. I thought it's going to go so much worse, right? And let's see how many profits we made overall in those three games which we played, right? So this is the third game, this is the second game, and this is the first game. So in first game with the Škoda, we made 99,000 profits, which is very good. Hip hip hooray. In the second game, in the Siegfried line, we made a solid 70,000 profits with a performance which was less than 3,000 combined. And in the last game, where we played for, I would say, good performance, 3,500 combined, we have 89,000 profits. So yeah, hip hip hooray, very nice. Overall, our performance with this beautiful tank is 3,400 damage and 100 assisting damage. Call me dirty, but I would call this a very, very nice score, and I think we played very, very, very well. So I hope you found this video interesting. I hope you found this video funny and informative, obviously. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed what you see, remember, you are one click away to make my day, so thank you very much for that, and see you very, very soon. That was your daily dose of skill, and skill is out. Peace.